Hey everybody, Bud Brown here. In this Tagalog lesson, I want to teach you how to say, I just finished doing something. In English, we can say, I just ate, or I just finished eating. I just got here, or I just arrived. In other words, you just finished doing something. And I'm going to tell you how to do that in Tagalog. There's kind of a little code that you have to remember, a certain conjugation of the verb. For example, a lot of times I would say, I just said. My wife asked me, what'd you do today? And I said, I just said. So she wasn't paying attention. So the way you say, I just finished doing something, I just ate, or I just played, or I just got here, or something like that. You take the root of the verb, and for example, I just said it, the root to say is sabi. So you take the root, and you have to do two things. You double the first syllable, so sabi, the first syllable sa, so sa sabi, and then you have to say ka in front of it, so ka sa sabi. And then, there's one more thing about this. It seems complicated, but once you get the hang of it, you'll get it. So, you have to say, Kasa sabi ko lang. I just said. And usually, when I hear this, or if I'm, it's not me that just said it, but my wife just said it. Maybe I'm not paying attention. Or she told me something, and I didn't quite get it. And I'll say, Ano sinabi mo? What did you say? Ano ang sinabi mo? We'll go over that another time. But she said, I just said, Kasa sabi ko lang eh. Kasa sabi ko lang eh. I just said. Okay? So, the rule is double the first syllable, preceded by ka, and put lang after it. So, I'll give you some more verbs and we can do that. I just ate. The root for ate or to eat is kain, kain. So you double it, kain, and then you put ka in front of it and lang after. So kakain ko lang eh. I just finished eating. Kakain ko lang. So there you have three kas in a row, but there is a method of why you did it. So, kain is the root. Kakain means you double that first syllable. And you put ka in front of it and lang after it. Kakain ko lang. I just finished eating. Now, here's another one. The word for to come is dating. But when you double that first syllable, da, for some reason, it doesn't. You don't say da-da-ting. That you go da-ra-ting, da-ra-ting, da-ra-ting. That da second da becomes a ra, r da-ra-ting. And then you put ka in front of it and long after it. So ka-da-ra-ting lang. No. Ka-da-ra-ting ko lang. I forgot to tell you. You have to put ko if it's you. If it's somebody else, you'd have to put a different pronoun. Kadarating ko lang. I just got here. So, I just ate. Just as a review now. I just ate. If we're going to go in order. I just said. Kasa sabi ko lang eh. I just ate. Kakakain ko lang. I just got here. Kadarating ko lang. That's the way you see, I just did something. Okay, I hope that wasn't too painful. So, you got the rule. And now, it's just a matter of practicing so you'd be more fluent. So, practice saying, kasasabi ko lang. I just said, kasasabi ko lang, kasasabi ko lang, kasasabi ko lang. So you say it enough times, it becomes a lot smoother and more. You become more fluent that way. Okay, thank you and have a good day. Till next time, bye-bye.